old and new art still bounce back to the fact that the present world now, the technology world, the effect on this so-called new art and the old art, which was more from within. Now, look at the artists, the so-called famous, the present ones now. The visualization, the exposure has affected the art. Look at the paintings we are painting now. Africans are not the color people. We are not the I want to make it colorful. No,
yes.
We're the down to earth,
color.
Brown, yeah. Mm-hmm. And that was what they appreciated. Now we are beginning to be like them, and in the real sense, and I don't know what the future would say or speak, but I just feel that the originality should always be there, even when we are being influenced.
And
by
are you saying we should stay on one place?
I'm not saying that we should stay on one place. I'm saying, irrespective of what we do, what we paint, what we sculpt, let our culture, that us, reflect on everything that we do.
For me, I believe that art should always be from within. And whatever thing you are, whoever you are, should be expressed in whatever thing you do. That's what makes the difference between artist A and artist B.
Yes.
Your character reflects on whatever work you do. So your exposure to will definitely reflect. Because, okay, for example, there's this, okay, this artist, please remind me, who went to Africa sometime.
Picasso,
yes. He reflected in his works.
Yeah.
And that didn't make him stay. He was just exploring. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So he moved.
Yes.
So there should be movement.
Shouldn't
you go to Europe, you paint. There's this man that won the France something one time, Adore, one artist like that. You know, they went to France and they painted, and he painted like a French person. You know, the painting was quite interesting. It didn't have the African measure because it was actually in Europe, and he painted so much, and you know, it caught the eyes of the white people. So we should be like that. Be influenced, and then of course you move.
Yeah, she just said it all. I beg to differ with what Omola said, because yes, we should inculcate the African culture in our paintings and all that. But Millicent, our first speaker, rightly said, our art is as a result of our environment.
Yes.
You know, tracing back up to our main topic, old and new art, she said art is art. Why? Because it's based on the environment. It's based on what we see around us.
Yes.
It's based on our orientation. And over time, it has our art has evolved. I'll call it,
mm-hmm.
it evolved, not necessarily old or new.
Mm-hmm.
Because I have a school of thought, if we say old and new, by the time our generation has passed, the next generation, what are we going to call their own art? We'll call it new.
Mm-hmm.
So actually, for me, there is no old or new art. And art, as she said, or as we have all been saying, is art.
So that means
there is old
that
and
means,
new art.
That means
maybe according to what you said, time.
Yes,
maybe time.
You cannot compare
okay, at certain time, you know, once at
the
particular time you grow old,
yes.
And there was this
yes.
time.
You
maybe
know,
maybe at that time.
You know the number of works produced in this era, then move to another era like that. So I think there's.
I'm sorry, I want to say this. When we are talking about trends, we should equally have it at the back of our mind that trend has to do with time.
Yeah.
Yes.
No. Everything in life is all about time. And since time is very, very, it's intangible things that we cannot really, hold or something like that.
So let me play on this.
I want to say that because of time, that is the time determine the past.
Yeah.
And then, if there is no time, there is no way we can even know yesterday, today, and the rest.
Yeah.
So, in as much that time will continue to still determine whatever we are going to do or be, I want to believe that there is past.
Okay.
Because time helps us to determine
yes.
the past, and then to know where we are now, and then where we are moving to. So, concerning the issue of concept, you made mention of one thing that you know, European. This mentality has always been with us. At the initial stage, we don't even appreciate what we have. And up to now, we are still being enslaved, you know, mentally to these colonial masters. And likewise, when we look at it, we embrace foreign things more than indigenous things. And those people over there, although we are tired of our own, but they are equally clamoring for our own. They want to have it, they want to enjoy it, they want to feel it. And the only way to make ourselves even popular and for them to equally embrace what we are doing or what we are is by doing our own things in our own way. Doing it in our own way, that doesn't mean that we are still in the past. Are you getting what I'm saying now? Sir. Because in those days, they use pigment, they use soil, they use stone, they use so many things. All these things can still be explored, and we are still exploring it. For instance, Ofili used elephant dung to paint Mona Lisa. And through that famous painting, Ofili was able to, you know, bag the award of British of BM here, or that is British something like that. A lot of awards were given to him. He moved from Britain to America to all part of Europe, you know, and they embraced that thing. And that idea that he used is from Africa here. If it is something that has to do with maybe paint, like hoi color or whatever, I don't think anybody will embrace it. Some people were curious, they want to see that thing. How can elephant dung be used to paint something?
In terms of old and new, can we, maybe the word is the thing causing the issue. The old and new, you don't want to be associated with the old, I'm in the new, so why should I do the old thing? How about we say modern and contemporary art?
Thank you. From here, I come in.
I wanted to ask.
I will say, thank you very much. If we continue this discussion, you people can see now. You can see how it is. To actually put these bright brains together, it cost me sleepless night. It cost me to actually go around knocking at doors and even stealing some people from their studios. But you see, we don't even want to live here now that we are here. With time, everything is set. Right now, it's time for discussion.
Yeah.
This discussion, we are moving it online. For you people at home, you want to contribute, you want to talk. I don't know who don't vex you for here. No to vex for online. I don't say people who won't write anything, they go write. Please, you will see our channel at 484 on YouTube. You can follow us on Facebook and, you know, join the conversation. It continues, it's actually endless time.